Winter is here and major storms are on the way.
I need help.
Sure.
We have unexpected deliveries.
It's a good thing Jordan's here.
I don't even know if me and Jordan can do it.
Complicated installs.
Whoa! Nice!
And most importantly, we have to get the roof on.
If anybody can finish the roof today, it's Kevin.
Today, we are calling in the cavalry.
Yeah! Woo!
And mustering all the grit, hard work, and professionalism we can.
Dun 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 dun. Dun dun. Yeah, it says everywhere, tailgate service only. Good morning.
Good morning.
How's it going?
Pretty good, I got your window.
Do you? Excellent, okay.
It's a hard climb.
Yeah, I'm amazed you made it. Thank you for coming up here.
I was almost not able to make it. There's wet spots and I was sliding.
Really? Just in time then, because next week it's going to snow, so that's perfect.
Yeah, I'm not going to be coming up much anymore.
Let me see if we want to shuffle anything around before you back in.
All right.
Okay, give me 1 second. Thank you.
Our windows are here.
That is horrible. Jordan and Kaylee are still here.
Yep.
And so we told Brandon and Grayson, like, hey guys, come in at 10. Like, take the morning off. We're going to, like, have breakfast with them and hang out. And then when you guys get here, we'll get to work. Not expecting the window delivery guys to show up at freaking 8:30.
I know. No phone call.
No phone call, and they're a tailgate-only service. They don't unload, and they don't carry the windows for you.
It's a good thing Jordan's here.
I don't even know if me and Jordan can do it.
Oh my God.
The good news is the windows are all the way up at our house. Last time when we had windows delivered, we had to pick them up down at the bottom. It was a whole thing. It was very complicated. So it's amazing he made it all the way up to our house. That's a huge plus. It's also amazing that the windows are just here in general before it's super snowy. Fantastic. Unloading is really going to be the only complication, and we're going to figure it out. We're going to think through a couple of different issues first.
Good morning.
What's up, Grayson? How you doing?
Doing good.
Our windows just showed up.
Oh, okay.
And the trucking company doesn't help you unload them. So there's just like a box truck full of giant windows, and I need help.
Sure. Yeah, I can come up there quick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, speaking of which, there's like 30 windows in that truck, and it's a tailgate service only, so. They pulled up and they're like, you got something to get these out? They're pretty big.
Oh my gosh. This is chaos.
Yeah, I mean, I'm ready to move them if we want to move them, but. Sure you don't want to move these? I could bring some of this Panamanian muscle. It's a little bit different.
Like, we could probably move like 80% of them, but there's a couple of those windows where it'll be really, well, I gotta wake up a little bit.
Come get some coffee.
I heard you like coffee.
Oh yeah, I love coffee.
Excellent, sure. Perfect.
I've been on coffee for like 4 days straight.
Perfect, come on in, have some breakfast. All right, so this is Shane. He's delivering our windows and we're gonna show him.
Are you ready for some coffee?
What's up with some coffee?
I grabbed up some coffee. Do you want some? Oh, getting there, man.
Yeah, we're moving some windows.
Remember when we went to that place in
It was in Guatemala. Yeah.
And that guy, that was like the weirdest guy.
Yeah.
Oh, they had the Japanese, like, weird, like, extraction of coffee that went up and down.
Yeah. He had it all, I remember. And he was like slurping out of a spoon. I was laughing at
Yeah, him. I remember yeah. that.
I'm like, what are you doing? Yeah.
They were like, what is wrong with this guy? Like,
now I do that.
Psycho.
I do that every day. Yeah. I am that guy. That's and so everyone comes in, they're like, what a psychopath. And I was like, yeah, it's great.
No, let me show you how to do it.
gosh, what a fun morning. We invited Shane, our window driver, in, and he has been awesome and so flexible while we were waiting for one more set of hands. Grayson is the closest person, so he just ran up really fast, which was amazing, because I guess there's 5,000 pounds of windows in this truck right now that need to be unloaded, and of course the driver has to go do another delivery after this, so we want to help get that unloaded as quickly as possible. So we had a really wonderful coffee tasting this morning, some amazing coffees brought to us by the very own Morning Movement, which were absolutely delicious. And I think now we are switching gears while Jordan and Kaylee are here. I know this is super unexpected for them. We're just putting them right to work. And we're gonna unload some windows. A big truck? Do you see a big truck? How you pictured your morning, huh, Jordan?
I'm honestly having a blast. I get to see Trent doing Trent things. It's great.
I'm so glad you guys are here. I don't know how we would do this without you.
Trent would find a way. I'm confident in that.
Okay.
Come check it out.
The infamous Airstream. Jordan and Kaylee have been traveling in a very fancy Airstream, and this is my first time seeing the inside.
All right. That's okay. He's gonna come in with us, okay?
Whoa. Look at this. This is like a spaceship.
I know.
Wow.
It just kinda feel that way.
Do you love it? Yeah.
Somewhat regret going with the light upholstery.
Yeah.
Because it's just so hard to maintain.
It's really pretty.
It's like, it feels very like clean.
Baby.
Like,
yeah.
You know, I like the lightness of it.
Yeah.
Hey, but stick on. Oh,
are you going to have a drink?
So this is Sadie's espresso machine.
Oh my gosh. Thank you, Shane. It was nice to meet you.
You're welcome.
Bye.
You too.
Thank you.
All the windows have been successfully unloaded. Brandon is here, Grayson's here, Jennifer's here. It's 10 a.m. and it feels like the day should be almost done. There has been so much happening already, but it's all good.
I just wanted to.
Bye, you guys are crushing it. Keep going. You guys are doing amazing.
See you soon. Next time we see you, you're going to be a lot bigger.
Say bye. You silly boy.
He's laughing.
Wait, bye-bye.
She said no.
No.
No, okay. You don't want to say goodbye? You want her to stay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. We'll be back soon, baby.
Yeah, we'll see them soon.
Bye.
Okay. Aww. It has been so much fun hanging out with Jordan and Kaylee and meeting little Sadie and letting Sadie and Leo play together. I'm so grateful and honored that they made the trek all the way up to our house. They're on a tight schedule right now, and this morning not only did they stick around for breakfast, but they helped unload those windows, just like unbelievable, and it just felt like old times. It was amazing having them, and hopefully we'll be able to see them very soon, maybe even in Panama. We'll see. They're on their way. They've got a bunch more states to hit on their trip, and we are back to getting things as fully framed as possible. Sheathing and roofing is in full force. How'd you get up there?
The ladder's up here.
Oh, how's it going?
Pretty good. You want my water bottle?
No, I got one for you right here.
I'm screwing together this beam that goes across here while we're waiting for the next TJI. We're putting all those up. We're almost done.
Nice.
Basically, we just need to get the beam up and over there. Brandon's making the last TJI that doesn't land on the beam. Come. So as soon as he gets done with that and brings it up, we'll get it hung. And then as soon as that beam's hung, I can move my ladder over here. And then we can try and get that beam in place, get it leveled, get it mounted and secured, do our layout, and then start cutting our TJIs to length that are gonna perch on the beam and then go up and go down. And at that point, we'll have 5 small TJIs and 5 big TJIs left.
Wow.
It's only 2:00.
Wow.
What do I believe? What makes me feel it to write you this song?
Grayson's got you.
2 hours a day, 5 months and a year. Oh, I loved you too long. You keep blowing me out, I keep holding you in. I keep asking myself, oh, why do you still hurt? Why do you still hurt?
Oh, wow. Boy.
I cannot decide.
Is it? Alright, careful, don't pull down too hard. I'm gonna snap in half. Brandon, can you stabilize my ladder?
Yep.
Okay, now you gotta get all the way to the outside.
Why do you still?
Oh my gosh. Billy.
the heck are you doing?
Whoa.
How sketchy was that?
A little sketchy, but at least it's done now.
It's always the silver lining. So we got a couple TJIs, and then we can start sheathing. Oh no, we got rim board on this side.
And all the eaves.
Yeah, yeah, okay. You chunk your shin? Ooh. Chunky monkey?
Yeah, some real slivers coming through. Yeah, we still gotta do the upper rim board up there.
Okay. Rim board down here.
Both pieces of rim board here. Basically 10 more TJIs, 5 on the bottom and 5 on the top. And then sheathing all the way up on both sides. Do our eave blocking and then our fascia board, all 4 sides. And then we can start sheathing.
Wow. Who's out there? Look at those hats! Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh! Brian's dressed up like
he's that is so
these
funny.
Are all these suspenders I had. Sorry.
Where's your hat, man?
My hat is so red.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Hi.
Guys, cool. These hats are a little Americanized. They have a brim that's sewn on. I don't know what that's for.
Thanks
but...
for changing your hat.
We could cut them off.
That is so
You've
funny.
You've got my glasses, and he's got the rest of the kit. Even in gray. Oh, nice.
We that just want a blue. So I got funny. Carhartt. Come
yeah.
on.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, that's right.
Please, some Carhartt.
All right, guys. This is our annual winter is coming barn raising party. We do this every single year, and Brian and Sean are the heroes every single year. You'd think that we'd learn at some point that, like, yeah, winter is coming and we need to speed things up, but it always seems to catch us off guard.
When you only have 3 months to build a house, because like, your guys' winters end so late and mm-hmm. start so early, I guess you're always in a rush.
That's true.
You gotta have a lot of friends.
Just a couple really good ones. That's all you need. Well, well, well.
Kevin!
Good morning. We showed up to the Trent Allie Mansion.
How are you?
I'm great.
We're so happy to see you.
I bet you are.
Oh, man.
How long has it been since you've been here?
A long time.
Long time.
Oh,
long
time.
Wow. Yeah,
probably it.
No! Like it doesn't fit. So these 5 TJIs on the top to do the rim board, and then you put your 2x block. If I just did a study like that,
my thing is I've got plenty of a waste where I don't.
Well, we should have done that. We built this in the valley. You know,
there's plenty of things.
How many years have you been here to tape and goop?
Three.
Is this the third one? Were you here on the garage?
For every roof.
Yeah.
Wow. There was a lot of snow on the ground when we helped the garage.
Oh, wow.
We're just excited for you guys to keep this pace because every year you'll have a new building structure.
Oh, my gosh. We're running out of land.
you got more land.
No more.
You should just put a Roomba up here, because then, like, you don't have to sweep it.
I think that's genius. I think that's a brilliant idea.
We need a construction-capable Roomba, so I don't have to sweep and vacuum all the sawdust every single day.
That's what we have kids for.
That's right.
What you're here for. You're here to walk around and pick up all the little squirrels.
All right, so Brian and Sean are over here starting to tape and goop the roof, which is a very important, necessary step for waterproofing that we are super excited about because there are still a couple spots that get wet whenever it rains on the roof over here. I'm in here with Kevin's kids. We're gonna start cleaning things up. Kevin, Brandon, Grayson, and Trent, I think, are gonna finish the roof in here. Is that the next step?
That's the plan.
We'll see how far we get. What do you think? What can we accomplish today?
The whole roof.
Really?
Huh?
No.
Maybe.
Oh, whoa. That would be cool.
Dad, we could do that because you're here.
Maybe.
If anybody can finish the roof today, it's Kevin. So that would be amazing. We'll see what happens.
All right, we are making progress by leaps and bounds. Sean and Brian's emergency roofing service came out and they helped us get this entire roof completely taped and completely gooped, which I think you're supposed to wait for an inspection, but we got rain and snow and all those things coming. So we're getting this done. As soon as that goop's dry, we're putting ice and water shield up because I'm not having a bunch of water leak into these brand new spaces. Not any more water than what's already been in there. But Kevin and I are up here working on this cricket. We've got about half of it done. We've got basically two more rafters to get installed, and then we could throw some roof sheathing on there, but I'm not putting roof sheathing on that cricket until we get all the roof sheathing on the main roof because I don't know if I have any extra panels. Mm. So I think Brandon has all the rafters cut down at the bottom and he's got web stiffeners on them. So as soon as Kevin and I get done with these rafters, we're gonna switch and basically move up here and start doing our
other rafters,
the main rafters. Got a lot of rafters today.
Holy moly! Look at that technique. Sean, the spread eagle.
You look too close, you're going to see things you don't want to see.
All right, let's try and give you a little bit of a view. What's going on here? So Kevin and I have built this little roof here that's basically going to kick snow and water and hopefully a little bit of ice either direction when it comes sliding down this top section of the roof and hits this section right here. It's gonna shed that direction and shed that direction. And then hopefully we'll only have to come up here and shovel this off like, you know, once a month or something, I don't know. It's gonna be a task that we have to do. After I get done snow blowing the driveway, I'll have to come up and shovel the roof off. But the good news is in the wintertime when there's lots of snow, falling off of here would probably be more fun than anything because you'd just like fall and bounce and slide and land in snow. Wouldn't be that bad.
I set out on a road that I built with my own two hands. I'm the fence on the resources to make the stand. I felt strong in the sun as I
hey.
Passers greed. So forgiveness together is phases in between. Baby, we're children of summer, we're meant to be free.
to get it to
go straight.
Go straight up.
Hey, shy. Ah! Our length.
Ah! Hey.
How close do you want with the outside wall? Perfectly.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah.
Woo!
I know.
Yeah, I'm not great. Finally caught it.
It was all me.
All right, so we've been out here working really hard trying to get everything done. We're blocking our center TJIs on the load bearing wall. That's all done. We've got part of a rim board over here. These guys are knocking out sheathing. Let me just say, it goes amazingly quick when you've got five people working and we are busting butt. But Allie made us a nice, delicious snack. We've got a couple of little pizzas right here. So dig in, boys.
About time.
Thank you guys very much.
Yeah, you bet.
I guess I'll just hold these.
Okay, you come down now?
No, yeah.
You don't like pizza, you can stay out there.
Kevin is using it right now. Do you want it?
Get yourself some pizza, Kevin.
What you didn't see was me raising my eyebrows behind my glasses.
So the goal for today was just get as far as humanly possible, and we've got about 2 hours left before we cut things off for the day. And it's going, I've got to say, faster than I expected.
It's going pretty fast.
Look
but
at
we
you
are
guys, first of all.
Yeah, we look like a barbershop quartet.
Come on, Brandon.
Yeah, Brandon, get in there.
Brandon's the drummer.
Different style.
Can we take a picture? Hold on, that's really cute.
There's a piece in my hat.
Oh, yeah, it's just coming off everywhere.
All right, now that we had a nice little snack, everybody had some pizza, we're gonna get to work. We're gonna finish the sheathing and put the roof on.
Under the palm trees in the California sun. Sand underneath our feet, the morning's just begun. I don't remember much from the night before.
You look very majestic up there.
9 3/4.
9 1/4, Kevin?
I think I said 9 3/4.
Yeah, 9 3/4, just like the platform.
9 3/4.
Whoa! Ah, nice catch.
Everything is working out unbelievably well. It kind of helps that everybody here today has done this before, so they know the drill. Everybody is pretty experienced. It's like basically the same role that we do every time with roofing, taping, gooping, blocking, roof sheathing, roof blocking. I cannot express enough how grateful I am for good friends who are always willing to help. We would never have gotten this far today without them. And you can tell by the weather, the storms are coming. Next week is not gonna look as nice. It's really, really amazing that we're getting this all done today.
Here down, it won't break on anything.
dog coming at you.
Woo!
I want to lock up this.
You're gonna swing into this window.
Okay, this is the sketchy maneuver of the day. These guys have planned far ahead. Lika, get out of there. Lika, unfortunately, has figured out how to get up here, and we keep telling her to go back inside, and she keeps not listening and finding escape routes and coming out here, which is fine. She's fine. But they are about to install this last piece of rim board on the exterior side of the roof. It's sketchy. We've got Brian and Sean rappelling off the edge of the roof. Kevin, Trent, and Brandon are gonna hand the rim board down. We're gonna nail it in place. It should go nice and smooth and fast as long as everything goes according to plan. Here we go.
Sean, ready?
Yeah, we're good.
Oh, easy. I'm not even carrying anything.
So I'm good.
That's good. I'm holding it all then.
Yeah.
I'm pretty good.
I'm easy.
I can be here a while.
Is it centered?
Flush it to the top if it's not good.
Man, this is hard.
Is it good?
Yeah! Woo!
Come over to the side.
Dun 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 dun. Dun dun dun.
That was almost cool.
I wasn't centered on the door. It worked.
It did work. How'd it go out there?
Easy, actually. It was really nice.
Good.
To plan. Yeah.
Guys, thank you so much.
See ya.
See you tomorrow.
You know, if there's one thing that makes me feel loved and treasured as a friend, it's having people like Kevin and Brian and Sean and of course Brandon and even Grayson and Jennifer, everyone coming together to come up here and help us in a time of need. Because I thought Brandon and I could get this addition framed in by the end of the year, and then
I mean,
we brought up.
You could, but
we could have, but we would have needed snowsuits for sure.
Yeah, exactly.
And then we brought in Grayson, and it sped things up, but not quite enough. And now we've had to call in Kevin and Brian and Sean and everybody coming together. We've been busting butt, and we are like so close to getting the second roof on. Snow is coming, but I think we're going to make it. But it's only because of all of our friends. So I just wanted to say thank you so much to the friends that have come in and give us a hand.
It's so true what they say. It takes a village, and we are so grateful and feel so special to be part of this village. Thank you.
So if you guys enjoyed coming along on this adventure, make sure you guys show us by giving us a big thumbs up on today's video. Consider subscribing to our channel if you haven't already.
Thank you guys. We love you.
And we'll see you guys on the next
one. Adios.